I'm here with Dr. Anna Purdy, and we're here to talk about heart health and how stress relates to the health of your heart. I know that most of us are pretty stressed out most of the time these days, and we're going to talk about how that's really not good, and what you can do and steps you can take. So can you kind of tell us what I'm going to be doing here today?
So you're going to be doing what's called an exercise treadmill test.
Okay.
And the first thing we need to do is hook you up to our ECG machine, and
okay.
So we do that by putting some electrodes on your chest.
Okay.
And then we'll hook you up to the machine.
Okay.
And then we'll check your blood pressure, resting, and then we'll start you exercising.
I'm ready. Let's
okay.
do this.
Oh.
It definitely was sandpaper, yeah. This is quite the process. Okay. I feel like a transformer or something. Can you tell me what a normal blood pressure would be? Okay. How did I do? 30 over 90. So a bit high.
Not too bad for getting on the treadmill.
I haven't even done anything yet. So I'm all suited up here, and Dr. Anna is going to tell us a little more about this test. So how exactly does it work?
So Sarah, what we have is we have you hooked up to what we call a 12-lead ECG.
Okay.
And we take your baseline ECG when you're just standing, and then we watch the ECG as your heart rate increases with exercise. The other thing we watch is your blood pressure. So what does your blood pressure do when we put the heart under stress?
Okay.
And then there are certain changes on the ECG that I look for that tell me that part of the heart is not getting adequate blood supply.
That's okay.
That's what we're here for, I guess.
Okay. Yeah. Is that jog or no?
I wouldn't jog this one.
Okay. That's fast. Can you kind of tell us like what your opinion is of, you know, people's stress levels in their lives and how often you see this sort of thing?
Yeah, you know, I think it's a really difficult time in Calgary. Lots of people have a lot of job and financial stresses, and often the symptoms of stress and the symptoms of heart disease are very similar. So people will, if they're feeling anxiety, have chest pain, have palpitations. So if you're under a lot of stress, your risk of heart disease goes up high. And then the other thing about stress is it seems to negatively impact our cardiac risk factors. Diet and exercise are the big things, and sleep. So a healthy diet as much as you can, regular physical activity. The recommendation is 150 minutes a week, which is tough to maintain. Watching your weight, getting good restful 8-hour sleep, watching your alcohol intake, all the sort of simple things that you can do.
I'm gonna amp it up to the last level of this test here, and then we'll get back with Dr. Anna after that and see how I did. Now I can run?
You can if you want, yeah.
So the test is over now. So, I know I'm a little sweaty, I don't know if you can see that, but Dr. Anna, how did I do?
So Sarah, you did great. So what we look for is that you reach 85% of your age predicted maximum heart rate. So
for someone like myself, what would that be?
I think you maxed out there at about 168, so that's perfect, yeah. And then I look for any ECG changes that tell me that part of the heart's not getting adequate blood supply, and there is nothing that makes me worry. And your blood pressure response to exercise is perfect. So overall, you get an A.
Yay! That's fantastic. Okay, so you would say that, you know, I'm on the right track to heart health despite my busy lifestyle?
Absolutely, it looks very good.